Okay, hi everybody, it's Tree. You know, when I say in my videos that I'm going after the crown, Queen Elizabeth's crown, you know, everybody laughs at me and stuff. Did you know that I have just as good of a chance of getting the crown as you do? Do you see my point? We all go after it together, everybody, all of us, and we look at them, the royal family, and the one, the queen, and all those people with all those rich titles and stuff, and crowns, and gold, and jewels, and gold carriages, and properties, and Queen Elizabeth owns and amends the United States Social Security since 1997, which means she owns us, the United States, as collateral, seeing if we can't pay off the national debt, national deficit, we're collateral. So it's basically we're commodity. They sit there and they buy around gold carriages and they have so much money, more money than... The throne of the Queen Elizabeth Bassett's in, okay, you see the Temple of the Holy Mother, okay, the Mothers of France, you know, all these different castles. And what that meant, okay, Jesus' mother, her name is Anna Marie, and she was in France and she was the queen. She sat in the throne that Queen Elizabeth sits in. Queen Elizabeth sits in the throne because it's the throne of King David, and the Bible and the Old Testament had a word that God tells everybody that he was going to make King David and King Solomon have the power of the militaries and the government and the people and the land. And that's really a real thing. It's a real thing. It's a real throne with all those real rights. And if you look at Queen Elizabeth's titles and honors, you know, the government, you'll see that she has dominion over every country in the world. It's between her and her husband and her son, Prince Charles, but really it's all her. And also in the United States, she takes power over the United States through the people who are leaders of the United States and tells them what to do in their secret society. So when they're in a secret society, they have to do what they're told. And if they're in a secret society, then the Lord, the self-proclaimed Lord that the bishop would bow down to is in another country, like Francis Queen Elizabeth. She is the leader of the Illuminati, the Freemasons, or anything. But so, okay, so she's a Great Britain. Let's say Obama, George Bush, Arnold Schwarzenegger, too. He's a member of Bohemian Girls, too, by the way. He's St. Karen now. He knows them always, but none of them are always there. But anyway, so people who are in our government, she doesn't run the United States, but she can tell the people who are running our United States what to do, and they have to pledge their allegiance to do whatever she says, even if she's in a different country. So here in the United States, if they say, hey, we want to do something, and then they're leader of their secret society, the queen says, no, you don't. And then they don't have to do it. They don't get to do what she says. Okay, my idea. Okay, when you get your crown back, then all that gold, all the gold carriages, and all the jewels, and the land, and the property, and everything, you know, that they had hoarded and stuff would be spread out among the people, and there would be certain people who would be appointed. Certain cities, certain states or countries, you know, like that. There's thrones. There's certain people that are running certain states, countries, towns, and cities and stuff. Now those ones aren't, they're all run by Sangarian, the Illuminati, who was appointed by the Queen. Mark my words, I swear to you. Not one single human sits in any one of those thrones that haven't been anything anywhere. So now I'm saying, let's go look at it and say, okay, first thing you have to do is you have to identify them, who it is, and they are the ones that are doing these things. Because you can't tell us, you can't take something back that's yours from somebody you don't know who's got it. But I've done this, I've thrown in my life, it's gone on 16 years since Easter, since I had that vision, and I've devoted in my life to retrieving the crown and reviving your birthright rights, bringing them back to you and taking care of the spoil. I don't want to be in charge. I'm just going to be the hippie healer. There will be people who will be in the politics and who, but politics aren't even like that word, but there will be other thrones and other crowns and seats and responsibilities that will go to all, each and everybody, and a different person. Okay, and like the kings, you know, like the knights of the grail, that's kind of what I'm talking about. Sons of Anarchy seem to be not enough in my proposition, but if we go, everybody, Okay, yeah, this is, all we have to do is go to the Sleeping Flower and we have to just, you know, get together, and then we all get together and say, okay, we're going to all get together, we're all going to summon the queen and the royal family, because they're the ones in charge of everything in any country in the world. Even the ones that are having wars with each other, you think they're on different teams, but they're still on her puppet street. She's Sangarian, and Sangarian is reptilian, which inhabits the human body, whose memories are intact for thousands and thousands of years. She is the bearer of Switzerland, the royal throne right now, because she inhabited Mary Magdalene. Here's Mary Magdalene, which, well, that man died, that man died. Jesus' daughter, Anna Marie, sat in the queen's throne in France, too, and her name was Mary, and her name was Marionette, and Jesus' mother was Anna Marie, and the castle was in France, and they didn't have the torture chambers, and they didn't have all that new stuff. They had, you know, people that would come to train them at castles, you know, and they would all have, they had all the wealth to train people to take care of the people and the orphans and the children and the families, making sure all the families had clean water and plumbing and everything until Caesar and Pilate and Herod and all those guys, you know. They, the kings back then, like Caesar, Herod, Pilate, anyway, they used to have permission and anointing by the Holy Mother in order to serve and rule. And they didn't like that. The very last authentic queen, and they didn't use the term queen, they would call the Holy Mother the incarnation of the goddess, you know, that they called Isis. So that's where it got kind of sidetracked too, is because it's just a long story too. Anyhow, Jesus' mother was the queen, and she turned the crown over to Mary Magdalene, and Jesus was called the son of David because he was the heir of the throne of King David, and him and Mary were supposed to be the ones that had the castles and all of those territories and the jewels and all the powers and all everything, the military, everything that they, that the queen was, but now has, was supposed to be Jesus and Mary Magdalene together, and when they would have it, they would have been able to have it, and they would have got killed and stuff, but Mary Magdalene got inhabited and Jesus got killed, but Mary Magdalene got tricked and got told that she didn't let the Queen Elizabeth, whose real name is Sheetoxis, she wouldn't let her inhabit Mary, she wouldn't let her inhabit her, that she was going to have her baby killed if Mary Magdalene was pregnant with. You know, that's the mystery about Jesus and Mary's baby and stuff. And so Jesus' baby and Mary Magdalene's baby was raised literally by the one Sheetoxis. The Queen, that's her reptilian name, but it's the Queen, and the Queen Elizabeth II now, who was also the Queen Elizabeth John then, and different entities throughout time. But she inhabited Mary, and so then she got Jesus and Mary's baby and got to raise that baby into that bloodline, which was just had been reinfused with this divine bloodline, the Meridian bloodline, which is compatible for the Sangarian to inhabit some card back or whatever. And so once that happened, then Elizabeth, inhabiting Mary Magdalene at the time, got Jesus dead and got the baby raised herself in that bloodline, where it said that there was a whole other, a whole other group of bodies, human bodies that were compatible to be inhabited by the Sangarian. Time, which is now running out. Right now there's more black girls being born because all of the really inhabit somebody at a certain time, then the bloodlines, every 2,000 years it has to be infused, the well runs dry, right now the well's dry again. There's no more human beings of pure black girls or the working bloodline that are inhabited by Sangarians, so the Sangarians that inhabit them now, when they die off, will be trapped in the abyss and never back here or not. I have bed than you had. And the pet is now hibernating in my bed with my permission, but God, I wish I knew how to talk to him excitedly, because then we could figure out how he has all the answers. He's the only one who's been a bed for Queen Elizabeth. He was the snake that made it even